Chapter 8.
Is that it, then? Your nogri have failed. So too bad, and on to more pressing business. You promised me Jedi, Grand Admiral Thrawn.
I promised you Jedi, and I will deliver them. What report from Wayland?
The engineering team has finished its analysis, sir. They report that the cloaking shield schematics seem complete, but that to actually build one will take some time. At least for a ship the size of the Chimera.
Fortunately, they won't have to start with anything nearly this big. Here are the specs for what we'll need in Sluice Van. And we're also going to need some advanced mining machines. Mole miners, I believe they're informally called. Have intelligence start a record search.
The engineers also report that nearly 80% of the Sparty cylinders we'll need are functional or can be restored to working order with relative ease.
Sparty cylinders? What are those?
Just that other little bit of technology I was hoping to find in the mountain.
And about Skywalker and his sister?
We'll use Team 4 next. Transmit a message telling them to withdraw from their current assignment and stand ready for further orders.
You want me to transmit the message, sir?
Team 8 failed me. Sending the message through you will let the others know how displeased I am.
And when Team 4 also fails you? They will, you know. Will you be merely displeased with them, too? Or will you admit your professional killing machines simply can't handle a Jedi?
They've never yet met any foe they can't handle, Master Sabaoth. One group or another will succeed.
On the other hand, Admiral, this attempt will have put them on their guard.
He's right. You can't fool a Jedi twice with the same trick.
What alternative do you suggest? That we concentrate on his sister and leave him alone?
That you concentrate on his sister, yes. I think it's best that I deal with the young Jedi myself. He is a Jedi. I am a Jedi. If I call, he will come to me.
I need you with my fleet. Preparations for the assault on the Rebellion's Sluice Van space dock facilities have already begun.
My assistance was promised only upon your promise to deliver my Jedi to me. I will have them, Grand Admiral Thrawn.
Why can't we do both?
Explain, Captain.
We could begin by starting rumors of your presence somewhere, Master Sabaoth. Some sparsely populated world where you might have lived for years without anyone really noticing. Rumors of that sort would be certain to make their way back to the Rebellion. Particularly with the name Jorah Sabaoth attached to them.
Very well. The plan is sound. I will go to my chambers now, Grand Admiral Thrawn, and choose a world from which to make my appearance.
Congratulations, Captain. Your idea seems to have caught Master Sabaoth's fancy.
I apologize, Admiral, if I spoke out of turn.
You served too long under Lord Vader, Captain. I have no qualms about accepting a useful idea, merely because it wasn't my own. My position and ego are not at stake here.
Let me get this straight, Captain Solo. You alone, and without consultation with anyone in official authority, made the decision to cancel the Bimisari mission.
I've already said that. I've also stated my reasons for doing so.
Which, in my opinion, were good and proper ones. Captain Solo's duty at that point was abundantly clear. To protect the ambassador in his charge and to return safely to alert us.
Alert us to what? Whoever these gray-skinned beings were, They clearly weren't considered important enough by the old Senate to even be included in the records. I doubt a race that insignificant is likely to be capable of mounting a major offensive against us.
Maybe they saw the old Republic's coming demise. They might have erased all references to themselves and their world in hopes the rising Empire might not notice them.
It can't be helped. If we don't protect our negotiators, the New Republic will stagnate and wither. Accordingly, you will detail a force to accompany Counselor Organa Solo on her trip back to Bimisari tomorrow.
Excuse me? Tomorrow?
Yes, tomorrow. The Bims are still waiting, Captain.
I know, but...
What Han is trying to say is that I had intended at this meeting to ask for a brief leave of absence from my diplomatic duties.
We're not talking about a vacation here.
I'm sorry. I, of all people, recognize the need to add new Jedi to our ranks. But for now, there are simply too many urgent demands on our time. In another year, possibly sooner, unless there's something more, we stand adjourned. You all right, Tim?
You know, it was a lot easier back when we were just taking on the Empire. At least then we knew who our enemies were.
Read for you by Mark Thompson.